We're going to talk today about profilometry, specifically the difference between stylus and optical profilometry. Profilometry gives us topographical data. That data can be in single point. We can do a line scan, or we can get an area scan. Some examples of this data that we can get would be surface morphology. We could get step heights. Or we can get surface roughness. There's a couple of different methods that we can use to obtain this data. We could use probe, or we could use light. First, we'll talk about stylus profilometry. In stylus profilometry, we have a probe that will detect the surface through contact. So we have something like this. It's a probe, and it will actually contact the surface of our sample. So say our sample that the probe will be in contact and move along that surface. So this is a point by point method. Now we do have some pros and some cons associated. Let's look first at the pros. You can get a very high Z resolution. We also do not care about the optical properties of the material, which we will care about for the optical profilometry. Cons. Probe can contaminate the surface since it's actually in contact. Alternatively, our surface can contaminate the probe. If we have a surface that easily breaks off or has dirt on it and it gets onto the probe, then our contaminated probe will no longer accurately measure the surface. We also have a lateral resolution limit. And you can see that if you think about what this probe is doing and the shape of it. So if we have a surface that's just perfect step, our probe is okay if we're here, but in order to get into this step, let's go onto this side of it, our probe will end up hitting the step before it's able to get into this corner. So we're not able to measure this corner. We have a limit on our lateral resolution. And that depends on our tip, size, and shape. We also have a very slow method here, because we are measuring point by point. So each individual point, we need to move our probe and then we need to collect the data. Optical profilometry is non-contact. This system analyzes light reflections in order to get the topography. We have a couple of different methods for this. So you could use optical interference. And I'll have different videos on each one of these as well. At least the ones that we have in the MMCL. You could use confocal apertures, focus detection, or pattern projection. In the MMCL, we have profilometers that use the optical interference method as well as the pattern projection method, and we have an optical microscope that does do the focus detection method. Between all of these systems, we do have some commonalities. The common components amongst all these systems are the light source, that there is a light source, maybe different for each one. We also have optical lenses, and image sensors. Again, the details of these will vary. Let's look at the pros and the cons. Pros for this system, this type of system. We get really fast measurements. This is because we're not measuring point by point here. Now we're measuring multiple points at a time, usually an entire area at once. Now the main cons are that it has difficulty with reflective or translucent surfaces. So remember how before for the stylus profilometry, we didn't really care what the optical properties were. If it can't see where the focus is, then the system is not able to determine where how the morphology looks, how the surface looks. We also need a very high level of cleanliness here. Any piece of dirt, any little bit of imperfection is going to affect these measurements. So there we have our profilometry overview, specifically the differences between stylus profilometry and optical profilometry. In the next two videos, we'll look at what optical interference profilometry is, and then also what pattern projection profilometry is.